Speaker Among, who was presiding over today's House sitting, told Parliament that she had received terrifying concerns of congestion in prisons by the Commissioner General of Uganda Prison Services, Dr. Johnson Byabashiza, who cried out to Parliament to do the needful.
Said, out of every 100,000 persons, 168 persons end up in prison. Now, all their prisons are full. They have no space for the prisoners. As we legislate, as we go through the budgeting process, we should be able to think about the infrastructure in prisons, not only Luzira.
Legislators decried the appalling state of prison facilities and acknowledged the need to improve them by addressing cases of case backlog.
This is now full. The facilities is full to the extent that they cannot contain even more. And yet the one who are inside there, when you interact with them, close to about 60 to 70%, they are in detention, sometimes without trials. You find somebody is arrested, somebody is in the prison 1 year, 2 years, without even going for trial.
There are many young people in massive prisons. They cause, most of them were arrested because they committed crimes due to unemployment. Uganda has a population of younger people that is almost 78% of the population. But the money that the government gave, the youth venture fund that government gave to the youth to begin their enterprises and went through Centenary Bank, it is very difficult to get.
Lawmakers claim the long stay of inmates in prison is one cause of congestion in prison facilities, advising the government to give attention to non-custodial sentences.
We have a lot of people who are in jail, and some of the cases, they are not being heard, which we should find lawyers to help these people.
As of 4th July 2023, the prison population stood at 76,083 inmates of 72,507 males and 3,576 females, representing a prison occupancy rate of 374.4%. However, some members of parliament suggest that the focus should be put on tackling the high unemployment of youths, saying that the majority of prisoners are youths who are forced into criminal activities.
80% of our youth are unemployed. To find a solution for the unemployment of our youth is very critical, and that would be a solution.
Uganda, as a country, we should protect the small business services that we have for our people. Because if you go right now to Kisenyi here in Kampala, you find that all the small businesses are done by the Somalis. If you go to Bunga, Buziga, Gaba, all the small businesses are owned by Eritreans and Ethiopians.
The Minister of State for Industry, David Bahati, say that several measures have been put in place to address youth unemployment, including commercialization of agriculture, industrialization, and service sector.
It's the issue of unemployment, job creation for young people who now comprise of 78% of our population. In addition to the development of human resource capacity, which is through skilling, like we have set up centers across all the regions, as government led by President Yoweri Museveni, we are also emphasizing key strategic areas that create jobs. The first one is commercial agriculture. And that's why you have seen investing in the parish development model.
The prison population has grown and doubled in the past 10 years, from 35,564 in 2012-2013 financial year to 76,083 inmates in 2023, representing an annual prison population growth rate of 8%. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.